What is up, everyone? Barricade here, and I'm bringing you guys my review of Dragon Ball Super Episode 51. And honestly, the first thing I just want to say off the bat is, holy shit, that speech that Black gave on why he wants to kill humans. That's just the one thing I just want to talk right away. Wow, that was just crazy. You know, he's basically just stating that the reason why he's killing everyone, killing humans, is because of the fact that he deems the humans a mistake created by the gods. Like, they're the only thing in the whole universe that is an abomination and pretty much a false and mistake that the gods should have never created. And that's why he's killing them. He's killing the humans because he wants to correct that mistake and do it for them, because they don't have, I guess, the courage or whichever to do it themselves. And that's the whole point behind Black. He's correcting that mistake. He's killing all the humans to rid the universe of their abomination and things like that. So that was pretty crazy and kind of interesting. Makes me wonder why. You know, why does this person hate humans so much? Why? And when it comes to the gods, maybe something happened in his timeline or his universe or something or whichever that made him hate humans. Maybe something happened to a god he cared about thanks to humans or something like that. It's kind of hard to say. You know, there's always a reason behind something, and there should be a reason why he hates the humans so much. And I'm pretty sure we're going to get that explanation later on, and it's going to be something pretty damn crazy, something pretty interesting. But anyways, overall, the episode was pretty good. You know, we got the explanation about the second time machine. If you haven't watched the Cell arc in a long time, then, you know, this would be a good explanation as to why, you know, why they have it. Bulma basically asked Trunks if she could have the second time machine before he left. And while the thing that's funny is, when I think about it, first I was mad that I didn't remember that, but then at the same time I realized that it's true. They never showed a scene with her asking to keep it. We saw Trunks take it. So that's probably why I didn't remember that there was a second time machine. I thought maybe he took it and it just got destroyed or something. But it was in fact because Bulma actually asked him if she can keep it. And she wanted to use it for repairs and learn off of it, but she could never do it. So that's why she never, you know, pretty much progressed with it or never brought it up, like in the Buu saga and things like that. And then it ended up helping them now that they really need it with Future Trunks and Black and all of that. And then, you know, we see that it's going to take a while for them to fix it. Goku asks Whis if he can be trained by him again. Whis doesn't want to. And they tell him to train with Vegeta. And that's the thing that I was kind of confused on. Vegeta didn't want to. Like, he didn't want to train with Goku. And then there's a part where he even says, I won't forgive him. Who's him? Who's he talking about? That's the part I was a little confused on. Is he mad at Goku? Is he mad at Black? Maybe he doesn't want to be around Goku after seeing what Black is like. Maybe he's mad because he thinks Black is really Goku or something. Not really too sure. It was kind of shady on why he said that and why he didn't want to be around Goku. But the thing that was interesting, though, is the part, speaking of Black, we see him in the future, and he's training, and he's doing, like, the poses and stances that Goku does, and you see, like, that weird little phase of, like, Goku's energy kind of, like, fitting in with him, and then he even goes on to say, this movement fits this body, and then he basically says, learning more about Son Goku will make me even stronger. So it's like, wait a second. So this is one thing I'm thinking. Maybe my theory, you know, my theory that I kind of expanded on in my other video, go ahead and hit it, I'll throw in a link in the description. I basically said that I think Goku Black is actually Goku's dead body from the future, and this Supreme Kai or whoever it is took it and is using it, and then that would explain why Goku never helped Future Trunks or Future Gohan by trying to communicate with him, with them in the future, I mean, like letting them know about the hyperbolic time chamber or something. I always thought that was weird that he never helped them. Go ahead and hit the link in the description. I'll throw my discussion video regarding that so you can go more into info. But the whole reason why I'm bringing that up is because that would point out as to why he liked to fight Goku so much, because he's learning how to use Goku's body by fighting Goku. So that was the thing that was just kind of a crazy thing to really point out and kind of, you know, state, because he was strong already, but after fighting Goku, learning his stances, learning his abilities, he's learning how to use that body, thus getting stronger. So that was just like, oh my god, what now? You know what I mean? This guy is just gonna get worse and worse. And then we see the things with Trunks, and you know, he sees mind. They show that she's the future leader of the resistance and things like that. And then that we get to see like the part where Shu and Emperor Pilaf are like, well, what about me? What about me? And he's like, I never met you guys. So I'm thinking Black probably killed them or something. They never explain why she was young again in the future timeline. So I'm thinking maybe in the future timeline, something similar happened. Something happened with Pilaf and Shu. They probably got killed by Black. And that's probably why she hated Black so much. Not just because he's an evil bastard who's killing everyone, but she probably has a little bit of a personal grudge against him in that regard. Because that would explain why they're not around. But overall, solid episode. Really liked it a lot. Explained a lot of cool things, you know, about the time machine. We got to see a little bit more of an insight on Black's character development and why he hates the humans so much. So that was actually really interesting. The last thing I want to point out, maybe someone else can tell me, you know, what she was talking about. At the very end of the episode, there's a part where little young Mai, is talking and she goes, oh, the guy with the mask was so handsome. Who's she talking about? Like, I was confused. Like, guy with a mask? I don't remember seeing a guy with a mask. The only thing that came to mind was, like, the Great Saiya Man or something. I don't know. Maybe the translation was incorrect and she actually said something else. Maybe she was talking about Future Trunks and she thought that Future Trunks was handsome. I thought that was kind of weird that the translation said that. It said, the guy with the mask was handsome. So, I don't know. But overall, solid episode. Really liked it a lot. Explained a lot of cool, interesting things. I'm going to go ahead and give it a solid 8 out of 10. Really liked it a lot. The one thing I just want to say is I know my reviews kind of be around the same marking, but that's because my older reviews kind of had like a bad scaling on the rankings. Like with the Resurrection F episodes, I probably gave them like 3 or 4s out of 5. But out of 10s, honestly, I would have gave them like 6, like 5 or even 6s at the very most, because the Resurrection F episodes were kind of bad, honestly. But these episodes are a lot better. So that's why I'm giving them 8, you know, 8 and 9s and stuff like that. But I just wanted to kind of explain that so you don't think I'm just giving the same exact ranking for every episode. But overall, solid arc so far. I'm really liking it a lot, and I cannot wait for more episodes. But anyways, guys, if you guys like this video, please definitely hit that like button, subscribe. I'm going to do more reviews and also more speculation videos and probably even Xenoverse 2 gameplay when it's out. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and take it easy.
Thanks for watching this video. If you want to see my most recent Gears of War video, hit that link on the left. If you want to see my most recent Dragon Ball video, hit that link on the right. Thanks for watching, guys.